If you watch any EnergySage videos or read our content online, you know that I spend a lot of time talking about the benefits of solar panels. They can lower your carbon footprint, reduce your utility bills, and even boost your home's value. And today is a very exciting day because I am getting solar panels installed on my own home. So follow along as we take you through installation day. Okay, so it's solar installation day, but let's back up a little bit to talk about how we got here. Because I walk the walk, I went to EnergySage.com. We went through the whole process, gathering quotes, and then we had multiple consultations with different installers. We talked to their EnergySage advisor, and they answered all of my questions about specifically my home, my energy usage, which was really cool. We decided to go with Viridis Energy Solutions because they had the best options for my personal needs. It took about It took a long time, but that's partly because it's my dad's fault. We got everything through all the approvals in February. Our permit application was accepted in April. And here we are in September, actually getting the solar panels installed on the roof, which is very exciting. We decided that a solar energy system that's 8.1 kilowatts or about 18 solar panels is best for my needs. It'll cover almost 100% of my energy use, which is really cool. I'm very much looking forward to my first utility bill. I know it's only day one, but I should have this entire system paid off in less than 5 years, which is really exciting. Solar installations typically take between 1 and 3 days. Most commonly, you can expect them to be there for 2 days, which really is pretty quick considering everything that they've got going on. First, installers will establish a safety perimeter and stage all their equipment, and then they install the racking system. So that's the foundation that securely attaches the solar panels to your roof. Obviously, a very important part of this equation. Everything is engineered to exceed local wind and snow load requirements. And since I'm getting this done in Boston, that snow load requirement, pretty important. While this work is happening on the roof, electricians will be installing the inverters. Those are those devices that convert DC electricity into usable AC electricity that I can use to power the devices in my home. Next up is the very exciting part. It's actually getting the solar panels up onto those mounting systems. So each panel gets carefully positioned, connected to its optimizer, and bolted onto that racking system, making sure it's safe and secure. So the 18 solar panels will be split between the east, south, and west-facing parts of my roof. Now, of course, south-facing is best for solar production, but unfortunately, the south-facing part of my roof is also the smallest part of my roof. So this way, with this setup, we'll capture the sun as it rises in the east and sets in the west to maximize my solar energy production. And then finally, they connect everything to the main electrical panel with a backfeed breaker, making solar power look just like any other circuit in the home. They are just putting up the last of the solar panels now, which means the entire installation took roughly 9 hours, which honestly quicker than I was expecting. And now we just have a little bit of a waiting game. We have to get utility and city inspectors out here just to make sure that everything is safe and good. And then we will get PTO, which in this case means permission to operate. And then it's game time. I'll be generating clean electricity and my utility bills will be lower. Thank goodness. And I just have to say, I would not be here today if it wasn't for EnergySage. And I know I work there, but seriously, cannot recommend the process enough. It was so simple. It was so easy to do. And it really connected me with installers that I feel like I can trust. So can't recommend it enough. EnergySage.com. And you too can lower your utility bills and generate your own clean electricity.